Gonna go ahead and get on started. Like I said before, the recipe that I'm using is from Vinny Guadagnino from Jersey Shore, his keto diet meal plan book. I'm using his book and we are doing shrimp scampi. So this is the recipe right here. As you can see, this recipe in a whole serves four. I'm doing a personal serving, okay? It's not for four people. As you can see here, you will need 3 tablespoons of grass-fed butter, 2 tablespoons of good quality olive oil, 1 tablespoon of minced garlic, 1 scallion or green onion, which is the same thing. Some people call it different. Now for this serving, you will need 31 to 35 pieces. For a single serving, you will only need about 8 pieces. You need 1/4 cup of white wine, juice of 1 lemon, 1/4 teaspoon of sea salt, 1/8 teaspoon of freshly ground black pepper, and 2 tablespoons of chopped parsley. Guys, as you can see, we have all of our ingredients here. This is the juice of 1 lemon, 2 tablespoons of butter since it's just for me, 1 tablespoon of minced garlic, the salt. I don't have any black pepper, so I'm using red pepper flakes. And we have some parsley. This is our white wine in here. I always say when a recipe calls for white wine, if it doesn't say a dry white wine, girl, use the white wine you like because you like the taste of it. It's gonna enhance the flavor and you need just some good quality olive oil. So I have everything here that I need and we're gonna go ahead and get started in the pan. All right, guys, so we're gonna put our pan on medium heat. I am using an electric stove. So I'm gonna go about 4 or 5, honestly, and let my pan start to warm up. So the first directions is in a large skillet, right here, over medium heat, warm the butter and the olive oil. So like I said, I'm doing 2 tablespoons of butter, and we're gonna do, let's see, the book calls for 2 tablespoons of olive oil. I'm gonna do about 1, just because, like I said, I'm cutting the serving size down in half. So I'm gonna take my olive oil, and I'm gonna do about 1 tablespoon along with my butter. Or should I do 1.5? Yeah, let's do about 1.5, just because, to make sure we have enough saturation of the food. So yeah, you wanna definitely get your butter and your olive oil all melted in the pan over medium heat. So I'm using a slotted spoon, which is just a spoon that has holes in it. I'm gonna be using this for the shrimp because you wanna leave as much of the juice and everything in the pan as you can, like the butter and olive oil. You don't wanna take that out. All right, so all of my butter and olive oil is nice and melted, as you can see. The next is to add your green onion. And remember, you only need 1 scallion. So this is about 1 green onion from me. You're gonna add your green onion and your 1 tablespoon of minced garlic. And you're gonna saute this all around in the pan for about 3 minutes, you know, or until it's nice and soft and fragrant. I'm sorry. Alright, you guys, so it's becoming nice and soft and sauteed. I can only tell because of the color change, especially with the minced garlic. and with the green onions, honestly. Sometimes it gets like a little more transparent. So then you wanna go ahead and you wanna add in your shrimp. So like I said, I have about a good 8 shrimp, and you wanna cook them until they're nice and pink. Normally you can tell when shrimp is done because they turn into a C, like a full blown C, and then you wanna flip them. The shrimp are starting to look so good, you guys. Like, they just look so tasty. Oh my goodness. So as you can see, the shrimps are very pink. And they're kind of, you know, getting tighter and tighter into that C formation. So that's how you know. Also, keep an eye on your minced garlic and your green onion underneath it, of course. It's getting all that flavor in there. Just from the olive oil and the butter. So now you want to remove your shrimp from the pan with a slotted spoon. That way you lose all of the oil and butter that's still in the shrimp. I mean, that's underneath the shrimp, because like I said, you want to keep as much of your juice as possible. So you're gonna add your white wine, and if you want to know, I think this is a Stella Rosa white wine. No, I lied. This is the Roscato Moscato white wine. You're gonna add your white wine. Ooh, I smell it. And you're gonna add your lemon juice in there, and you're gonna bring that to a boil. You know, let it start boiling up, cooking around. As you can see, it don't even look like it's a lot of green onion and garlic in the pan, because it's really not, honestly. You know, bring this to a nice good boil. All it's gonna do is thicken up slightly from a boil. And then you're gonna remove your skillet from the heat, okay? After you see it boiling really nicely. This is such a quick meal. I mean, it only takes about 10 to 15 minutes, honestly. Like, the cook time is 10 minutes. The prep time is about 10 minutes. You know, peeling your shrimp, cutting everything up. From the heat, and it says to put your shrimp back into the pan. Yes, and you want to constantly like hold it around. You're gonna put your shrimp back into the pan. You want to go ahead and add your salt, add your pepper, and like I said, I'm using red pepper flakes for mine because I don't have any pepper. Yeah, so we just coating everything all around. And also, I would say you can use red pepper flakes if you like more of a spicy, you know, flavor to your foods rather than just, you know, subtle black pepper. Because to me, black pepper is very subtle. Where you get your really spiciness is from like cayenne, red pepper flakes, all of that. And now what I'm gonna do, this is what I do. I take my slotted spoon, I remove my shrimp once again. You're gonna add them back in, don't worry. Then I go ahead and put in my zucchini noodles. Remember, I don't know if you guys heard. So I pair zucchini noodles with mine instead of regular noodles because it's keto shrimp scampi. So you gotta let go of your, you know, pasta noodles. And zucchini noodles, I mean, it was very good, you guys. I made this once before. Zucchini noodles was very good with this. And I believe the serving size for this is a half a cup. A half a cup cooked. So this is about that. Definitely want your noodles to grab like everything, okay? You want them to grab it all. So I'm just really tossing it around. Also, the pan is kind of warming up the noodles. Of course, they were just cooked. There, you know, you get you a steam bag of zucchini noodles. Nobody spiraling this on their own, okay? All right, you guys. So now what I'm going to do is I like to grab my zucchini noodles, place them in the center of the plate for presentation-wise. All this is presentation, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and place them in the center. You know, make it look like a rich meal, okay? Of course, you're gonna see all the juice come from around it. Get all your noodles. No noodle can get left behind. All right, so I like to place my zucchini noodles there. Then I'm gonna go ahead and place my shrimp going around the stack. And it's literally the perfect number of shrimp, you guys, literally. I'm gonna take the rest of the juice that was left in my little bowl as well as the pan. Take my parsley. You know, parsley is decoration. It's decor, if you didn't know. Parsley also keeps things very fresh, though, if you really want to know. And there you have it, you guys. This is a keto shrimp scampi recipe out of Vinnie Guadagnino's Keto Guido cookbook. I called it something else earlier, but the Keto Guido cookbook. I truly hope you guys enjoy this meal. I literally do. It is absolutely delicious. And this is a single serving size. So imagine all of them carb pasta noodles and how much calories, you know, and fat is being stored in the body from just eating a carb pasta. I'm telling you, you would not go wrong with this. I truly hope you guys enjoy, and I'll catch you in my next video.